Y bienvenidos a otro episodio de Aprende Español con Twitter. Hoy, todos los tweets dicen: pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero. I was thinking about giving to you something the 14th of February, or when we have a form of pensar with a verb with an R on the end after it, it's kind of like planning, so I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February. Las palabras comunes son algo, mejor, y pero. Now go ahead and figure out what they say before I tell you, and pause the video if you need more time. Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero, pero ¿qué? I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February, but what?
Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero, pero soy pobre.
I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February, but I am poor.
Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero, pero no tengo novio.
I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February, but I don't have boyfriend. And the A is implied there. Notice they say tengo and not yo tengo. Since the O at the end of tengo means I, we don't have to say yo unless we want to emphasize or clarify who has.
Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero, pero ya no. Estás feo.
I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February, but not anymore. You're looking ugly. Ya no is a great phrase. It means no longer or not anymore. There's a spelling error here. Estás with an accent mark over the A means you are. Estas without an accent mark means these. And then also notice that usually we'll probably use eres feo or eres fea for you are ugly. But when we use estás feo or estás fea, it's saying you are ugly in this moment. You are ugly now. You're looking kind of ugly.
Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero. Pero mejor.
No sé.
Me mato.
I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February, but better yet, I don't know, I'll kill myself. Notice here that me mato really says myself I kill, but in English it would sound better to use the future, I will kill myself. And also notice that things are often backwards between languages.
Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero, como un chocolate o algo así. Pero mejor te doy mi vida y mi tiempo.
I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February, like a chocolate or something like that. But better yet, I give you my life and my time. Notice that te doy actually says to you I give. And again, it's very common that you'll notice differences in word order between Spanish and English.
Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero y decidí darte mi vida, amor y apoyo incondicional.
I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February, and I decided to give to you my life, love, and unconditional support. Notice the word order in apoyo incondicional. It actually says support unconditional, since the descriptions often go after the thing they describe in Spanish.
Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero, pero entre los collares para perros que encontré, ninguno decía tu nombre.
I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February, but among the collars for dogs that I found, not one said your name.
Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero, pero recordé que no tengo dinero ni trabajo.
I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February, but I remembered that I don't have money nor
a job. Notice that the letter Q is an abbreviation for K, and you'll often see that used a lot on the internet as shorthand. And there's a spelling error here. Recordé should have an accent mark on the last E to mean I remembered. Y uno más. Pensaba darte algo el 14 de febrero. Un oso que diga te amo, por ejemplo, o un anillo, por ejemplo. I was planning on giving to you something the 14th of February. A bear that might say I love you, for example, or a ring, for example. Notice here that it says diga instead of dice, which is normally how we say he or she says, because it's showing the doubt that this bear even exists. Te amo is one of the ways to say I love you in Spanish. Another way you might come across is the phrase te quiero. Te amo is the stronger one, and te quiero is the not quite as strong one. We could range from I care about you all the way to I love you. Well, that's all for this episode of Aprende Español con Twitter. If you'd like to, write your favorite tweet in the comments section, or write a comment with the hashtag from this video in the comments section. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for updates on new Spanish video lessons. If you wanted to start the tweets from the very beginning, you can click here. If you wanted to see the last episode, click here. Or if you wanted to see the next episode, click here.